So in this video, we are going to explore Nanite, which is a new feature of Unreal Engine 5. So yesterday, Unreal Engine 5 launched and it's a big deal. Like, there are a lot of features that they announced. So I'm really excited about this. I'm going to do a UE5 breakdown video later. But in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Nanite, their new polygon streaming technology. And by using that, you can essentially import high quality 3D assets inside Unreal Engine with hundreds of millions of polygons. So you can essentially have millions of triangles on your screen being rendered in real time. So now on screen, you can see all of these models, and each model right here has 500,000 triangles, 500,000 polygons. And there are hundreds of models right here. So essentially there are around 100 million triangles, and it's being rendered in real time inside Unreal Engine 5. Okay, so let's create a blank project. So I'm going to launch UE5, and we are greeted with a new launching interface, a new project browser. So I'm going to select a blank project. You can name your project to whatever you like, and I am going to keep it to blueprint for now because we are not going to do any programming in this video. And you can turn off starter content because we don't need that. And you can turn off ray tracing as well because we are going to use Lumen for this. So you can just create your project now. And as you can see, this is the new launcher screen for UE5, and this looks pretty cool. So this will take some time to load. Okay, so first off, a completely new UI right here, and this looks quite streamlined and quite minimalistic. I really like this, and they have also redesigned all of the icons, all of the gizmos. So you'll find all the tools on the top. So the selection tools, the landscape tools, the foliage tools. On the right hand side, you have some similar panels. You have the world outliner and you have the details panel. On the top left, you have the cinematics panel. We also have the blueprints panel, the content panel, and we have the create button. So this is quite new. After this brief overview, I'm going to select the reflection capture and I'm going to delete that. You can also delete the player's chart. After that, you can select the skylight and you can change it to movable. So just change that to a movable object. Similarly, select the sun lamp and you can change that to a movable object. Okay, so now it's time to actually import our high resolution model inside UE5. So I'm going to head back into Blender, and this is the model that I've got. As you can see on the left hand side, this model has 500,000 faces, and actually this is not modeled. As you can see, this is actually 3D scanned. So this is made using photogrammetry. It is really dense in polygons. So this is not at all ideal for games. This model has been scanned and created by this guy. So if you want to download the model, you can simply go to his Sketchfab link. I'll leave a link down in the description. Okay, so right click, import the model. So just import this. As you can see, after importing, you are greeted with all of the import settings. And now we have a new option for Nanite. So you can enable Nanite right here inside of the import settings, but we'll import it later. Leave everything to the default settings. And you can just import all. So this is going to import the model, the textures and the material. So just open up the model, and as you can see, just to confirm, we have 400K polygons right here. Okay, now let's close that and let's add this model into a scene. So I'm going to just drag this model in my scene. You can also press Ctrl L and you can move your mouse. And by doing that, you can change the lighting of the scene. Now I'm going to duplicate this by Control W, and I'm going to duplicate this a bunch of times. Okay, so now we have two rows of these models. So we have a lot of models right here. So there's some strata for sure. I don't think if you can see it right now on the screen, but I am experiencing a lot of strata. So it's time to enable Nanite for this model. So just open up the static mesh. After you open it, note the number of polygons, and in the Nanite settings, just enable that and just apply the changes. So this will take some time to calculate and bake the Nanite mesh. And just like that, we are completely done. We don't need to do anything else with this. And if you now take a look at the number of triangles, previously we had 500,000 triangles and now we only have 2000 triangles. So there is no quality loss. As you can see, the details are preserved and the details are maintained. So this looks pretty good. Like, this is basically magic. Like, this is really quite powerful. So I'm going to just duplicate this now. And as you can see, UE5 is handling this really well. I have a 1060 and an AMD Ryzen 1700 series, 1700X. But as you can see, this is working really well on my machine. And I'm running this in the editor. So if you build this, if you have a game and if you build this, you will get much better performance. So you can pretty much use every mesh and you can use Nanite to optimize it. It is just one button, you just press it and the engine does everything for you. So you don't need to do anything. So I'm really surprised. And yeah, I hope you like the video. Leave a like down below. It really helps a lot. Also, if you want to support the channel, you can head over to my Patreon page. I upload all my assets and all my project files on my Patreon, so you can download all of that good stuff there. So if you are interested, I'll leave a link down in the description. Lastly, subscribe to the channel. And yeah, that's it. I'm going to see you in the next video.